Well, my name's John Pederson. I've been living here on and off for 20 years. We've got 100 acres down at Summers, which is part of the old Coolart estate, which was a massive estate that was broken up in the 70s. The land we have is basically drained swamp, so it's heavy soils, which absorb a lot of water. In winter gets very wet, and in summer gets very dry, but if we get a good spring, we get a very good growth of grass. I farm sheep here, and sheep only. They are considered a rare breed, and they're called Wiltshire Horn because they got the old-fashioned big horn on the rams, and they are an old English breed that shed their wool, so they're basically bred for their meat. This farm sits on the edge of Coolart Bird Sanctuary, which has been preserved to look after the ibis and water birds, and our plan is to maintain this ecological niche by doing revegetation with indigenous plants. So we have created 17 acres of wetlands, which are ephemeral billabongs and deeper billabongs, which allow the wetland birds to come and nest here, and in so doing bring in beneficial insects, and that again helps my pastures. So the aim is to blend into pre-existing indigenous land value, but by trying to do sheep at the same time, so commercially and aesthetically pleasing. Establishing shelter belts is a long-term project because you have to let the plants grow up before any animals can get in, and you've got to predict how the trees are going to grow and what you're going to inherit. Sheep require shelter not only from the rain but from the wind and the sun. They spend at least 30-40% of the day chewing their cud under shade, and so we inherited shelter belts by the edge of all the pasture paddocks, but there are problems with those in that you get changes to the underlying grass, so we have gone and created new shelter belts as well. So we fence off all new shelter belts for up to 7 years to allow the trees to establish, and then we see what actually the indigenous seeds that are in the ground that come up. So we've been very surprised by some of the plants that have appeared probably after 100 years that are growing now. And then if I'm allowed, we put sheep in for a short period of time just to get the grass down for a fire hazard maintenance, and then they're out again. So they're probably only in for 2 to 3 weeks of the year in the spring. And that way we are establishing good shelter belts for the plants, and in this area koalas have become endangered. There used to be 20 years ago we used to see koalas every day, and now we may see them 2 or 3 times a year. So there's a big push to try and re-establish properties that allow koalas to walk through along corridors. Regenerative farming is very varied depending on who you talk to, but the idea is to improve the soil and the ecosystem on your property slowly with minimal inputs of any artificial stimulants. So we are trying to do that by two methods. We're using sheep manure, composted pig manure, and keeping the grasses long so as to keep the water in the paddocks for longer so there's more growth. And so I regard myself as a lazy organic farmer. I try and do as little as possible to the land. There's no point fighting it. It knows what it wants to do. What we try and do is stimulate it slowly. And my view of regenerative farming may be very different from somebody else's, but our ultimate aim is to improve what we have for the next generation.